Rev up your engines! If your car's tires could talk, they could tell you a lot about your car. And in the case of this tire, it's a good thing they can't talk, because you might go to jail for tire abuse. Now sure, tires don't have tongues and can't talk, but they do give out signs. And just like sign language, they can tell you a lot, if only you understand what the signs mean. So today, I'm gonna show you 10 things that your car's tires can tell you about the shape your car's in. Now, tires, they grab the road with friction. So the friction eventually wears them out. Well, tires have tire wear indicators on them to show you it's a sign for a new tire.
And as you can see here, this tire is worn down to the wear indicator. I mean, the whole thing's worn out in the middle too, but when they get worn down to the wear indicators, it's definitely time to get new tires.
All tires have them. You can check them every once in a while. And if any of them are worn down to the wear indicator, time to get a new tire. Now, the next sign that your tire can tell you there's a problem with your car is when one side of the tire is all worn out and the other isn't. That's often the camber adjustment on the front and alignment is off. Now there's various do-it-yourself kits guys sell to let you align your own car, but really, they don't work all that well. Go to a professional front end alignment place and have that done. They use laser machines these days, extremely accurate. So if you see one side wearing, just don't go buy another tire because it's gonna wear out too. Have the alignment fixed. And realize that excessively worn ball joints, springs, tie rods, they can also cause one side wear. So of course, before you get a car front end aligned, you want to check the suspension system, jack it up, pull on the wheels, see if there's play, and you have to replace the obviously worn things first. You can't align a car that's got a wobbly ball joint. The thing is going to bounce all over the place. You always have to fix the obviously broken things first, and your tires, by the wear, are going to show you there's a problem. Now the next sign that your tire can give you is heel and toe wear. Where going around the tire, you'll see the tread has toe one, heel the other, and it's heel and toe the whole way around. You want to check the suspension bushings, the ball joints. Any worn parts can do that. But one of the main reasons for that is if you don't rotate your tires, if you have no problems in the suspension at all, and you don't rotate your tires, you can get wear like that just because the tire is in one position the whole time. So you want to rotate it to move it around so that they wear evenly and don't wear heel and toe. Now the next thing your car's tire can tell you is if you have flat spots. Some have tread, some are flat. Now flat spots are often drivers that are really aggressive. If you slam your brakes on, it's gonna skid and eat a flat spot. So in that respect, cars don't get flat spots like they used to all the time because anti-lock braking doesn't allow your tires to lock up like that. But of course, if you do burnouts, that can create flat spots. And if you let your car sit for excessive periods of time, storage, and the tires are on the ground, they kind of flatten out, you can often get a flat spot because they're sitting at that part for an extended period of time. And especially if there's any corrosive liquids or anything around, that can eat into that part of the tire if it's sitting for a long time. If you're really gonna have a car sit for a long period of time, you best to jack it up in the air, put it on blocks or jack stand, and not have it resting on the pressure of the tires. I had a guy with a Porsche a month ago, and he let it sit for a long time. He took it out and he said, man, that thing was shaking like mad in the highway, but it's not doing it now. It did after I first got it going. So I said, would you leave it on the ground? He said, yeah. I said, well, it's sitting there squashing down. And it actually made the tire flat on the bottom a little bit more, so it was out around, but once he drove it, it stretched back out, went back to normal. I drove it around, didn't shake at all. The next sign your car's tires can give you problems is feathering. It's kind of like heel and toe, only instead of going around the tire, it goes across the tire. It's feathered wear. Now sometimes it's even harder to see, but when you put your hands on a tire and feel it across, you can feel the feathering. You gotta always check the ball joints and tie rods and make sure that nothing's physically worn. But if nothing's physically worn and it's feathering, generally that means the toe-in adjustment on the front alignment's bad and you need it aligned. But then again, like I said, if you got a problem in the front end, That can cause it too. So don't just think, you just get it aligned, that'll fix it. You gotta have the front end checked. That's why you need a good front end mechanic, because they're supposed to check all that stuff before they do an alignment. I've had a lot of customers over the years come to me and say, well, I went to a front end alignment shop, I had a front end aligned, but the car's still shaking, or the tires are still wearing. They don't just align it, they're supposed to check everything. And if they went to one of these chain stores where the guys put it on a machine, align it, where they go, they're not good mechanics, they don't check all that stuff, it's not gonna be a good alignment. It has to be by someone who checks everything correctly. I've seen some guys that perform alignments, they didn't even check the tire pressure. So if one tire's high and one's low, and they align it that way, the alignment's gonna be off. It has to be done correctly by a pro who knows what he's doing. So my advice is always try to find a guy who knows how to align cars, ask your friends, and stick to them for years. Because, hey, if they're not honest, they can sell you all kinds of stuff that you might not need. Now, the next sign, when the tires have outer edge wear. The outer edges are worn, but not the middle. That's a classic sign of an underinflated tire. If you don't have enough pressure in it, then the middle isn't sitting right, outer edges are grabbing more, and they're gonna wear up. You're riding on air, basically. And that absorbs even more shocks than the shock absorbing system does. If you underinflate the tires, it'll ride poorly, the shock system won't work right, and the tires will wear on the edge. Simple thing to prevent, just put air in your tires to make sure that they're correct, and do it first thing in the morning when it's cold outside. Because as they warm, physics tells you, heats up, the pressure reading goes up. You do them ice cold, that's when you check your tires. Now the opposite of the outer edges wearing is the middle of the tire wearing while the outer edges aren't. That's a classic sign of overinflation. Too much air, it makes the middle bulge out and it's gonna wear out faster. Most guys don't overinflate tires because you put too much pressure. One, they ride a lot rougher. Most people want a smoother ride, so it's not that common unless somebody doesn't know what they're doing and they just put too much air in the tire. Or they have gauges that don't work right. I personally like this AccuTire digital gauge. The digital gauges are extremely accurate. They give you half pound readings. They're very easy to read instead of one of those old fashioned stick ones where the springs can wear out and the line comes out and it's kind of hard to read. These go in half pound increments and give you very accurate reading. Now let's say your tire pressure is fine and you're still getting center wear. That's a classic sign of your wheels and your tires are not matched. The wheels on your car are made for a certain size tire. A lot of guys attempt to put ones that are slightly bigger on, or sometimes slightly smaller, and you can get wear like that because they're not matched. This is all designed by computers. You don't want to take a rim designed for one tire and put a different size tire on. It may fit and hold air, but it won't wear right. So be wary of goofy modifications like that. Now the next thing your tire might tell you is it's got a diagonal swap that goes diagonally across the tire. This often happens on front wheel drive vehicles on the rear tires, meaning that the toe-in adjustment on the alignment of the rear is wrong. Yes, when I was a kid, all we ever did was front end alignments because the rear ends were solid axles. There was nothing to align. But most modern cars have independent suspension. So you need a front end alignment and a rear end alignment if you're getting weird wear like this in the back. Now, if your back tires are wearing perfectly normal, doesn't pull or shake, you don't have to do anything. But if it is worn like that, that's often the case is that the toe-in's wrong in the back. Now I do see this every once in a while on people who put really heavy loads in their trunk and leave them there. Because sometimes all that heavy weight, it just messes with the suspension geometry and they can wear that way. So all bets are off if you carry a ton of weight all the time. Now the next thing your car's tire can tell you is if it's got cupped wear. It's from worn suspension parts, but often that comes from worn shocks or struts that it's bouncing and it ends up making this cupped wear all around the tire. Out of balance tire can also cause some cupping. Of course it'll be shaking then too, you really can tell quite easily if it starts shaking. That's why if your car does start shaking at certain speeds, get it fixed sooner than later, because if you wait later, one, you're gonna wear the tires out. If it's an out of balance tire and you catch it before it's got bad wear, the tire can still last a while. If you wait until it's all cupped, well, then you're gonna have to buy a new tire. Why buy one if all you have to do is have it rebalanced? Many tire balancing methods these days use stick-on glue weights. A lot of times they just fall right off. So you might take a picture of all four tires, see where the tire weights are. And then if you look later and you see one of them's gone, you know, hey, it has to be rebalanced. I see that all the time. Now the last thing your car's tires can tell you is cracking or bulging in the tire. A lot of them will just crack from old age. Means it's time for a new one. Rubber only lasts so long in Earth's atmosphere with all the corrosive stuff and the ultraviolet rays of the sun. They start cracking, get new tires. And definitely if they start bulging out. Bulging out is a sign of one of two things normally. You hit a giant pothole or something and it's broken the cords inside the tire, or it was just a poorly made piece of junk tire. And as crazy as it can sound, it can take a while. You might hit a big pothole and then look and everything's okay. But it can be days or weeks later that the weakness there comes out and then the air starts pushing the rubber out and you see the bulge. Think back, if you see a bulge, has anybody really whacked a curb or hit a giant pothole recently? And that causes the beginning of what becomes a big bulge, which means time for new tires. So now you know, even though your tires don't have tongues that can't talk, they do speak sign language. And now you know what those signs mean about your car. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.